the League of Extraordinary Frontmen, a podcast where four lead vocalists from four different Connecticut metal bands try to cram their egos into one room to talk about comic books, Star Wars, sci-fi, and anything else that comes up.
I'm waiting to be impressed.
So grab your underoos, strap in, and set your phasers to stun, because it's time for the League of Extraordinary Frontmen on the Metal Syndicate Podcast Network.
Entrance.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is episode 69. The Anarchys are celebrating at home. This podcast was recorded on...
Okay, I got the image. All right, you can continue. Go ahead.
This podcast was recorded on Sunday, March 26th, 2017. We are your hosts.
Agrippa from Agrippa 93.
Scotty, a.k.a. Rick Sugar, who is not here.
Celebrating at home with his wifey.
Kevin James Frear, celebrating with my wifey here right now in front
of naked.
YouTube gents.
And I'm glad you feel comfortable enough to do that in front of us.
I feel like it's a mouthful.
I need to like gouge my eyes out.
It's all good.
But later we're gonna have Martin and AJ celebrate for show and tell.
No, we're not. AJ from Amplified Video Productions.
And unfortunately, Jeanne is not here. She's an irreplaceable part of the show. And Scotty's not here either.
Yeah.
Scotty's not here either.
Yeah.
He's replaceable.
Lady J's not here either today. So.
Michelle from Space is here.
Hey, Michelle. Yeah. Hey. Good to have you back.
I'm here. My mouth is not swollen, so I can celebrate for today.
Well, you did the 69 for 69 minutes. It was great.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm glad that you were able to, you know, have that stamina.
Yeah. Unfortunately, Facebook does monitor that shit closely, so that video was ripped right down.
Yeah. I commend you for your
there was a lot of Viagra.
Dedication to the 69 show.
Be sure to tune in for live show and tell.
All right, what do we have on the show? We have no guests, so there is no guest host interrogation. We have a host question. I took a quick peek at that. Didn't read the whole thing, but I'm glad that we have one. Odd comic, another one that I like to be surprised by. We do have nerd news.
Oh, so you just like to be surprised by everything.
Yeah. That's my excuse.
He's
for not
surprised
looking
that we have a show some weeks.
Sometimes.
Oh, we're doing it? Oh, okay. What show?
Oh. Hey, I do get confused between podcasts sometimes. Right?
I know, you're busy.
It's getting up there.
Do we have who news? We may by the time it comes
to
home.
We might.
Who news? We'll see. We have no new toys because Scotty is not here. I requested that he send me some pictures and stuff so that we can just kind of rub through it. But we'll see how it goes.
Maybe we'll just Google search new toys and just make it up.
It's probably that easy.
We should.
We'll test it out.
I wonder if that's what he does.
No, I think Scott.
Hey Siri, what new toys came out this week?
Yeah, this is driving over. All right, that looks cool.
All right, we'll give it a shot. We'll see. We'll test that theory and how easy it
we'll
is.
Ask Siri.
Yeah, we'll let Siri do the new toys.
Siri, describe all the new toys.
Scott, you've been replaced.
We have live show and tell. We have shameless plugs. Woo. Cool. Let's kick the show off with the host question, because we're skipping a whole bunch of shit. Who came up with the host question?
Me.
Go ahead and read it.
With the triumphant return of Voltron over on Netflix, what other classic cartoons or live-action TV shows from the past would you like to see have a similar revival?
Ooh, that's
and if any of you guys say Gilmore Girls...
No. There's no Gilmore Girls love here.
Does it have to be a cartoon or a TV show? Could it be a movie that we want redone?
No, it has to be a TV show.
TV show or cartoon. Right. Yeah, because I think we
talked
about movies.
I'm laying down a line. That's
all right.
There you go. Let's see. I'm trying to think of shows I used to watch when I was a kid. Buck Rogers would be pretty fucking cool.
Mm. Oh, yeah, yeah.
So they already did Battlestar Galactica, and they did that fucking well.
You know, Buck Rogers would be fantastic. Because, yeah, I mean, like, even that show, like, it deviated from the comic strips.
Yeah.
So, like, you know, if they brought it back, they could do something that was maybe, like, kind of a mix of the two.
Yeah,
that'd be with the special effects.
Yeah,
nowadays.
It'd be outstanding.
Yeah.
I think we need another space kind of show right now.
Yeah, Buck Rogers is kind of falling off the radar. Like, you know, like, they always kind of bring back Flash Gordon every now and again.
Right.
And Tarzan, those, you know, those types. But, yeah, Buck Rogers.
We need a Buck Rogers show.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
No.
Yes.
We're just talking about it. Okay.
AJ, you get the lights.
Yeah, come on. You got some cameras.
Yeah, what the hell? We're doing it now.
We'll send them a demo video.
I'm off the clock right now. So.
Do it live.
Let's see, what other shows did I watch when I was a kid? Dukes of Hazzard, but I don't want to see a remake. It's already been done.
No.
And I'm kind of embarrassed that I used to watch that show.
The movie was funny.
18, they did.
You know what, though? Like, with Dukes of Hazzard as a kid, like, you didn't realize... You didn't know what rednecks were.
Right.
You know?
you were just watching for Daisy Dukes. You were just like, yeah!
That's true.
Yeah. Well, it was just like...
Look at that ass!
I mean, to me, it was no different than, like, a fun adventure like Knight Rider.
Yeah.
Knight Rider.
They did redo Knight Rider.
And
recently.
It lasted four episodes?
They keep trying. Like, every, like, 5 to 10 years.
I love Knight Rider. You can't hassle the Hoff in that.
What was that helicopter show?
Airwolf?
Was it Airwolf?
Yeah, Airwolf.
Yeah.
I don't remember
there was a couple.
Around the same time as Knight Rider.
There was one with Jan Michael Vincent, and then there was another one with Dana Carvey.
Oh, my God.
I'm serious.
Yeah, I don't remember Dana Carvey on Airwolf.
Let's redo the other one.
But there was another one, yeah.
And wasn't that based off of a movie?
I'm serious, Dana Carvey.
I think there is a movie,
I'm not sure
which one is based off of the other.
And then they made the TV show after it. That might be pretty cool.
I'm going to IMDb.
Well, why he's looking that up.
Yeah.
I would have to say, probably. Does anybody remember Bucky O'Hare?
Mm-hmm.
There is a company called, independent toy company called Fight Boss Studios. Is actually making a line of those figures. I've never seen it before. I've never seen the show before.
I remember it as a kid. It was this green rabbit from outer space and like his crew, and they would take on like this like evil toad army or whatever.
Oh my God.
And they would travel like through space and everything to just battle. It was such a badass too.
Yeah.
Like everyone else was all like, oh, you know, take it easy, you know, blah blah. You know, we gotta promote peace, love, and he's like, no, bang, and like shooting.
They did a fundraiser for, or what do you call it?
Crowdfunding.
Yeah,
whatever. For it, and it got a tremendous amount of feedback and funding for it. During the break, I'll show you.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
They're fucking great. This company, I've ordered shit from them before.
That would be cool.
Make customized figures.
Yeah, I would definitely look into that.
Yeah, really highly detailed.
Yeah.
It was Blue Thunder.
Blue Thunder, right.
That was the one with Dana Carvey.
But if I had to pick anything else, I mean, like, I would say Batman the Animated Series, but it was so iconic,
so
and just leave it alone the way it is. I know they tried doing something sort of reviving it years ago with Beware the Batman, but it was more CGI, but they wanted to keep it like
that dark
Bruce Timm kind of feel
love
to
that.
It.
I love that.
And
movie.
I think it lasted about a season or two, like maybe halfway through season two, and then Cartoon Network canceled it. It wasn't bad. It was different, but it wasn't bad. And it was mainly dealing with villains that were like B or C listers, you know, way before the Joker or anybody else. So it was okay. But if I had to pick any other two, I would love to see them revive or redo the original X-Men series from the 90s.
Oh, that would be cool too.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Especially with everything going on with Marvel right now.
That would be cool, but it would ruin it. I think they would definitely ruin it. That was another one that was just so iconic.
Amazing Spider-Man too. That was
I
a good
never
one.
Watched
oh,
that
Spider-Man
one.
And His Amazing Friends was the best cartoon.
Oh yeah. Yep.
Good.
And that one still holds up. Like I've seen it pretty fairly recently, and it's not bad.
It's campy, but it's not bad.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
I'd have to agree with
Kevin
that.
And I just watched last night, and I don't know. We talked about it while we were watching it. I don't know if I'd want them to redo Who Framed Roger Rabbit because it was so well done originally.
Yeah.
But I thought about it. I was like, well, what if they redid it and it was still just as good? But I don't know if they could. It's along the same lines as if they redid Batman the Animated Series.
Yeah, like, I don't know if it would be better or worse, but it would definitely be easier to make now.
Oh,
it would be easier to make, but that movie doesn't really need a facelift.
Oh, no,
but
it
was just so good, but I wonder if it would be even better now, like adding some more different characters.
I love how Mario was in that movie.
Yeah, like everybody was in that movie. I remember I told Kev when we watched it.
That was such a terrible Super Mario Brothers movie.
Yeah. We watched it last night with Lou.
Here you go, let's do a reboot of that.
And I'm watching it and I was like, I remember that was one of the first movies I saw in a theater when I was a kid. And I remember walking out of the theater with my mom, and she goes, oh, did you like the movie? And I go, yeah, I really liked it, but next time, can we see a new movie? Because it's set in the 40s, and so I had no idea, like, that a movie could be set in the 40s, that it wasn't actually made in the 40s. Yeah. Nice. And so I was like, that was a cool movie, but can you bring me to see a new one next time? But I think it would be really cool. Maybe have it set in the 80s this time. Yeah.
That would be
pretty neat.
I'm frantically searching through cartoons that I used to watch. I'm trying to remember the name of one in particular.
Oh, I've got a million that are going to pop into my head on the way home.
I know they tried reviving the Thundercats years ago, and they didn't really do too well.
Thundercats is one that... I wouldn't mind seeing, like, a revival of that. The problem with that, though, is they would do it in a different style, kind of like when they brought back He-Man.
They probably modernized it a little bit.
Yeah. It kind of loses its charm, at least in my opinion. Yeah. But as far as, like, TV shows, like, I would love to see, like, Netflix take on Quantum Leap.
That
would
be pretty cool. Oh, yeah.
Like, modern take on it.
That yeah, or awesome. Or even just continue it, from where it left off.
Yeah, see where he left last.
Firefly.
Yeah.
That's always a sore subject.
You know, I think with... There are certain things that should just be left alone. Yeah. I think Firefly's at that point.
Firefly can't be rebooted. You can't reboot that show.
Everybody's expectations are so high.
Yeah, you'd have to do a continuation of it.
I love how they fucking Easter egg that shit in that Deadpool fucking cameo in the beginning of Logan. There was like a shit ton of Firefly posters behind him.
You know what? I'm thinking about that. I know it's been remade at least one or two times, but I think it's due for another revival as Attack of the Killer Tomatoes.
Oh, wow. It's got to be done right.
It was never done properly.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they had a cartoon of that.
Oh, it was great.
Yeah, I remember that.
I loved Attack of the Killer Tomatoes, but it's just never been done properly.
I just found the show I was looking for. It's called G-Force.
Never heard of it.
Oh, I kind of remember that.
Sounds like a porno.
Hello, my name is Linda G-Force.
There might have been.
Yeah, they're in a rocket ship.
Trying to find the G-Force.
Here's a little info on it. It premiered in 1986. Description is, G-Force, Guardians of Space is the second American animated television adaptation from Japanese anime series, Science Ninja Team Gotcha Man, following Sandy Frank Entertainments. It was a really cool show.
Yeah.
It was almost like a Voltron.
It was also called Battle of the Planets.
Could have been.
Yeah.
Yeah. I would love to see that come back. I mean, I used to watch that show all the time.
I got one. Silverhawks.
Silverhawks is cool, too.
Yeah.
Golden Girls.
A little weird. Golden Girls would be weird.
Golden Girls would be awesome.
Except, if they did Golden Girls, I don't know if you've seen...
all of them,
One Day at a Time?
Oh, yeah.
Have you seen the remake?
No.
Okay. They made a remake of that show with... Obviously a cast of brand new characters.
Yeah.
None of them really matched up
to
the original.
Yeah.
Names are all different.
Oh, well, that doesn't make
characters are all different.
So it's a completely different show.
It's a completely different show, and they just attached the
name to
it.
Just called it One Day at a Time.
Yeah.
No, Golden Girls would have to be four older women living in Miami.
Yeah, you at least have to have, like, the same premise.
Yeah.
I want that same set.
I want them to
just move into that house.
This might piss off Scott if he's listening.
Gilmore Girls.
No. I know there's been a lot of talk about the success over the Power Rangers movie that just came out.
Yeah.
I would like to see them redo that, but not with the same campy bullshit that they've been doing for the last 20 years.
Yeah.
But maybe, like, turn it into an animated series.
Yeah, would an animated series be as successful?
don't know, but I would give it a shot. You know,
I think the one reason why I kind of steered clear of Power Rangers. I mean, first of all, I kind of aged out of that.
Yeah.
But I think the main part that steered me away from it was that it was like really campy and really cheesy.
See, that's why I liked it, because it was just so.
I couldn't take it seriously.
That was half of the fun of watching the show for me anyway.
Yeah, because I think I'm kind of with you there. Mm. You know, we're pretty close in age. I think I aged out of it because, like, production value on that one probably isn't all that much different than like Captain Power.
Yeah,
yeah.
And I love that show.
Mm.
But you were too old to appreciate it. For Power Rangers,
mm-hmm. Yeah, and you know, plus I mean, Power Rangers outlasted Captain Power, but Captain Power was awesome. That'd be a good one. Bring the toys back, mm-hmm. Bring everything back. Shoot at your phone. Shoot at everything that plays TV.
I think I might be interested in a Power Rangers, like a modern day Power Rangers, that appeals to fans of Power Rangers. Of that have grown up.
Yeah.
So that YouTube video that came out, like, was it?
Oh, yeah. That one was cool.
That, like, adult version with James Vanderbeek in it?
Yeah. I think they'd have to go somewhere in the middle.
There we go.
Oh, come on. You never saw, what was that movie? The Car Salesman or whatever? That stupid spoof movie where,
The lot, or whatever it was called. Yeah, I did see that.
Yeah, what's his name? Ving Rhames. They're all in their hotel rooms. Everyone's watching porno in their hotel rooms. James Vanderbeek turns on Dawson's Creek. Ving Rhames turns on Dawson's Creek. He's like, James Vanderbeek, my nigga. Oh, like,
well, now we have the reference.
I would love to see Animaniacs come back. I know they have it on Netflix. It's all the older stuff.
I was
just
thinking about that today.
But on Nickelodeon,
it's outdated
though. Yeah.
I mean, if you watch it, I watched several episodes of it. Like now, as a full adult, I mean, it came out when I was adult.
It was very topical at the time for a kid show.
But it's like there's so many references to things that
are just outdated.
Nobody would understand today.
Yeah, no.
You know, like as I was watching, I was like. Nobody would get this.
Yeah.
I think if they made it more modern, it'd be fucking awesome. Because that was such a good show.
It was great.
I'm curious to see the new DuckTales.
Yeah?
That trailer looked good.
Yeah, David Tennant's doing the voice of Scrooge McDuck.
That's right. I did read that. That was Who News.
You didn't see the trailer for it?
News.
No, I haven't.
All right, we'll show you during a break or something. But it actually looks really good.
Yeah.
No, I did read that for Who News 1 week. I just, I don't remember.
Darkwing Duck.
Yes.
Yeah.
When
that
there's
would
trouble,
be,
you
yeah.
called
awesome.
W.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Darkwing Duck.
You could have the Duck Power Hour.
Better watch out, you
I would
bad
watch
boys.
That in a
Oh, my God.
Gummy Bears and Chippendale Rescue Rangers.
Oh, my God, Gummy Bears. Oh, that made me so happy.
Oh, Gargoyles was pretty cool.
Gargoyles was a good show.
Yeah. I liked it mostly because it had Jonathan Frakes and Marina Sirtis.
Absolutely,
it reminds me a lot of how Batman the Animated Series
I think
was.
It might have been the same... artist, wasn't it? The animation was very similar. I'm sure it inspired from Disney.
I think Disney did Gargoyles
because once Batman the Animated Series came out, a lot of other animated shows coming out were kind of similar to it.
It was
that
phenomenal.
One also appealed to adults.
Oh yeah.
Yeah,
I would rewatch that show.
Did you guys ever watch The Littles?
Yes,
I like that one too.
I don't think I've ever heard of it.
There are these little people, like the size of action figures.
2 inches tall, I think they said they were.
Oh, okay. So, yeah.
Or three and three quarters.
So they didn't matter. So, yeah, you guys.
1/24th scale.
But, like, they would construct, like, things out of, like, common, household items.
Yeah.
They make, like, cars out of, like, all sorts of crap.
Yeah.
With buttons and rubber bands. What?
The Fraggles need to come back.
Fraggles, wow.
Remember Fraggle Rock? Aww.
This may be straying from the subject, and it may be leading to maybe a possible another show topic, and you guys can decide if you want.
Family Matters?
No. What?
The Cosbys.
Urkel's Revenge.
It's kind of related. What animated show would translate well into a live action show?
Oh.
And vice versa. We already mentioned Power Rangers.
Yeah,
I think actually Power Rangers would be cool as a cartoon.
Especially with the reboot that happened, I think it would be awesome as an animated series.
Golden Girls? No.
But vice versa, something that was animated into a live action.
You remember the Gilligan's Island cartoon?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that didn't work.
Oh, wow.
The Star Trek animated show, too, was kind of...
They had some good stories on
there.
I would say X-Men, but they're already doing it.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Fox is doing an X-Men
show. They did Smurfs.
Yeah, that sucked.
Oh,
the Snorks.
Snorks? That would
they
be
were like the Smurfs, only they were Snorks.
That's true, yeah. didn't they mix universes one time?
Did they do a crossover?
I
Smurf
think they
versus
might have.
Snork? Well,
the
yeah, because they were both.
I don't think there's a battle or anything, but. Yeah. I paid good fucking money to see that.
Revenge of Snork.
It's like Battle Royale.
Yeah. Out in the field, just
Papa Smurf with his hands cut off.
Yeah.
Save the children.
Yeah, they're just smurfing and snorking everywhere.
Snork corpses piled up.
Snorking and then smurfing.
We just got our smurfing at home.
Let's see.
It would be the smurfiest.
Blender and snorking.
How about Hannah the Barbarian?
Hannah the Barbarian?
I think that was called. I'm mixing things up.
Yeah.
Hanna
Barbera.
Hanna Barbera. What was that Barbarian show that they had?
Conan the Barbarian.
It wasn't Conan.
No?
Thundar?
Yeah, Thundar.
Yeah.
I wonder how that would translate into modern, like.
I'm trying to
sounds
think
like
Thundar.
He's special needs, like Thundar.
The
Hanna
Barbera cartoons were always like really. always really kind of shittily made.
Yeah, well, they were rushed to production
a
lot.
I would say Xena and Hercules. Xena
would be a
cool
animated.
But it did
animated.
Translate
they
into
did
an animated...
They,
Xena
they
did.
It was an animated movie, though, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah,
huh. Well,
I don't think
that.
I saw it, but...
I loved Xena.
Yeah.
Me too. I'd like
were
to see that
were they voiced by
back.
The original actors? Probably. Yeah, I think so.
There was talk of bringing that back.
Oh, that'd be cool.
I know Kevin Sorbo is on Supergirl right now. Along with Terry Hatcher.
I can't get into Supergirl.
If
either.
You can get past the first episode, it gets better.
I've tried watching three.
It gets better.
Oh, dude, did you watch last week's Flash? The musical episode?
I'm so far behind in Flash.
Ugh, it was.
I told you, it's on CW. Get your
Danny
liners ready.
I like musicals. I'm sorry. Like, I thought it was good, but whatever.
No, that was the shittiest episode. That was the fucking worst.
When he turned
well,
it on.
Well, I mean,
all right,
come on.
I'm not
Dustin,
in favor of that.
He's
I
got
didn't
a background
like the musical
in
Buffy
singing.
Oh,
he also
yeah,
was on Glee.
I'm glad John Barrowman was on it. Because
Jesse
got great
plays,
voice,
who plays Detective Joe West, he was actually in Rent on Broadway. So that's actually him singing, too. So.
Oh, yeah.
Jesse played who in Rent?
I'm not denying that they have talent.
Mariah would not.
I'm just saying that it was a very poor episode.
It was very awkward,
like,
yes.
From a writing point of view, like, it was just...
Who
was
it?
A really
music master? Music meister or something? Yeah. That was,
shit like that takes you out of the...
Out of the world.
It was just
world,
just something to distract you from the story.
We don't know what
still,
the fuck to write this week.
Yeah.
Let's
the thing is, like...
It's the actors.
Yeah.
Like, oh, I have a singing voice. I want to do a musical.
Yeah.
Let's all do a musical. Woo. Fuck you. Stick to the original.
Okay, what cartoon?
Hey, I'm sorry. I enjoyed it.
Make
like...
a musical.
Akira.
Power Rangers? No.
Akira the musical?
Yes.
Akira!
Make it.
Starring Meatloaf.
Starring Meatloaf, yeah.
It's been so long since I've heard your singing, man. It's
I would call that singing. But you can't hear me singing April 1st.
That's how you do it.
You can also hear me, too.
I'll be there.
Singing along.
Oh,
no, I'll be singing along.
One day.
One day.
You and I will
Woo-hoo.
Be on stage.
We're
going to
collab.
All right. I think
we've
meandered enough.
We've kicked this horse enough.
Let's go ahead and do Odd Comic.
That was a good topic.
And, yeah, it was. And then we'll take a break and go into news.
All right.
I tried hard not to look at this Odd Comic, so
it's pretty
good. I won't be surprised. Kevin, you want to set the mood?
Odd Comic. All right. To set the mood.
Without reading
turn
it.
Turn your lights way
without
down
even
low.
Reading it, just before you start. without even reading.
You just see $5 and you're like,
I'm seeing like chicks dancing around, money coming out. Oh, yeah. I'm like, oh, this is gonna be fucking
good. I guess
good.
I'm gonna have to read this one.
All right, go ahead.
Is it the chick saying it or
it's Archie. That's Archie. Oh, even
better. I thought it was.
Oh yes.
Who is that? That's even Veronica, better. Right? No, that's Betty. That's Betty.
All right. So it's an Archie.
She's next in line.
she's next. Running. I'm next.
Okay. So in the foreground we have Reggie and he's holding up a $5 bill, showing it to a girl. We have Archie behind him. With his wallet in his hand, looks like it's empty, and he's saying something. And we got Betty running in the background; she's all excited.
She's got her hand up. She's ready.
Sweater with some vibrant sweater puppies.
I wonder if these mini shorts.
She's very pretty.
I wonder if the TV show is this exciting as these odd comics because Riverdale is on the CW.
See, if they capitalize on these. Like these particular,
they would have outrageous ratings. Yes. It would also have to be on past 10.
Yeah. All right, go ahead. I'm sorry.
So
very welcome.
Yeah. So who wants to read for Archie? I think you should do it.
Yeah.
All right. AJ is Archie.
Hey, Reggie just touched me for $5.
Yay! Go over to YouTube and check it out.
What will he do for $10? That's what I want to know.
Yeah. A full reach around.
15 for the Dirty Sanchez.
Reggie's a crack addict.
20 for a rusty trombone.
Reggie just needs that money for rock.
Yeah, he's we'll a crack whore.
Yeah.
Jesus. Oh my god.
I have to assume that must be like 50 slang for something. Like you touched me for $5,
I don't
con me out of $5 or something.
Are they playing like touch football?
Yeah, who knows? Yeah, maybe it's
with
that.
Their wallets out?
Don't you?
I'd like to see the frame before this.
No, of course.
And
no,
after it.
No, then it would be funny.
That would destroy it.
Well, it would just be traumatizing.
Right, well, we need to make the cells before this and after it. Then.
Reggie, yeah, that could be a fun. Oh, yeah.
Reggie wiped his face off before he took $5.
Like, create a page based on one of these.
Oh my god, that would be so much fun.
The listener that submits the best before and after frame gets to touch Scott for $5.
That is a deal.
Send all of your artwork to leagueofextraordinaryfrontmen@gmail.com.
We know who's already on it right now.
Yeah. You will not get to touch anybody for any amount of money. So sorry.
All right, let's take a break and come back with news.
Here's AJ with the news.
Oh, he's so adorable.
Now, we're recording now.
Yay!
Disney's chief reveals new details on upcoming Star Wars films. Details on the upcoming Star Wars films are usually harder to find than Death Star plans. But Disney COO Bob Iger just dropped a few key details about The Last Jedi and the untitled Han Solo movie in an on-stage interview on Thursday. Yes, continue reading. Thank you. Iger was being interviewed by the dean of USC's Einberg Journalism School, Willow Bay, who also happens to be his wife. Okay. When Bay asked about the galaxy far, far away, according to reporters in the audience, Iger was more than forthcoming. On The Last Jedi in theaters this December, Iger confirmed that Mark Hamill has a big role. We'll do a lot of talking. The Wall Street Journal's been... Okay, that's helpful. Okay.
Why you skip down to the Han Solo
stuff? Okay, all right. As for the young Han Solo movie, Iger revealed that the film will follow Alden Ehrenreich's smuggler hero all the way through his late teenage years and into his 20s. It's an origin story that will include Han and Chewbacca's very first meeting.
Aww.
The timescale represents a departure for a Star Wars film, except for the brief prologue in Rogue One.
Now, current, or I should say past Legends material says that Han Solo met Chewbacca when he freed him from slavery.
Yeah, but that's out of the...
That's out
of,
yeah. Well, what if they're going to take any of that?
Yeah, they might.
And use it.
Well, one of the interesting parts of this, if you don't mind me interjecting...
I don't care. Finish it.
Is that that Bob Iger also said that it will be talking about how Han Solo got his name.
Oh. From his
parents. Not his original name.
Yeah.
All right. That's cool.
He popped out of his mom's vagina and she says, I call you Han Solo.
That would
be, I mean, it could be as simple as that.
That would cover it. Yeah.
And Woody Harrelson also revealed the name of his character, and it's not who everyone was thinking it was.
Isn't he the one that teaches Han everything he knows?
Well, he said that he plays a guy named Beckett, who's kind of a criminal and a mentor to Han. So there's the name of the character that everyone thought he was. I think it's essentially the same character, it's just a different name.
Mm.
That's not as exciting.
Well, it's Woody Harrelson. I'm sure it'll be some.
You know what's great about Nay?
That's wrong.
Be some.
Well, you know, they look the same. I think they're the same person.
Did you want to keep going with that, or do you want me to move on?
I think that's pretty much it.
This is another one that Kevin got for me. Cartoons meet culture at the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles exhibit.
Yeah, of all the times for Scott to miss.
Mm.
All
right.
Springfield, Mass. At the Springfield Museums, the most famed names in the art world hang on the walls. Leonardo, Donatello, Michelangelo, and Raphael. Of course, we're talking about the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. One of the museum's newest exhibits has managed to find the culture in cowabunga. The exhibit is called Turtle Power, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and Samurai Heroes. The Ninja Turtles meet samurai warriors, said Julia Courtney, curator at the Springfield Museum. The museum has combined Japanese armor and treasured woodblock prints with the pop art of Ninja Turtles, memorabilia, and paintings.
Yeah, so it's kind of like a cool combo.
That would
yeah.
be really cool to
yeah.
check out. Is it close by?
Does it say how long it's open for?
It's going until like September 3rd.
September 3rd.
Field trip.
Admission
yeah.
is $18 for adults and $9.50 for kids 3 to 17.
Sweet. Cool. Let's do it.
Yeah, I'm down. That would be really cool to check out.
How much damage do you think Luke could do?
Oh, we could walk out of there as paupers. Yeah, for sure.
That's fair.
Just waiting on this one to load. There it is. Venom movie listed as horror-science fiction.
Hmm.
Because who would have thought Venom would make news?
who even gives a shit that they're making a Venom movie? I saw Spider-Man 3. It was terrible.
Maybe they have learned from their mistakes.
The Venom movie is becoming more and more real. Earlier in March, Sony Pictures gave Venom a release date. Now the film also has a production date.
Whoops. Yeah. I said Sony and my hopes went down the drain.
Well, yeah.
They're working with Marvel now.
Yeah, true.
Let's wait till Spider-Man comes out and see how that does before,
yeah.
like, jumping the gun.
I'm sorry, but that trailer looks good. Like, that Spider-Man trailer looks
oh,
good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's, I mean, it's, odds are it's going to be a really good movie.
Yeah.
But this just kind of seems like a little too soon.
Yeah. According to the industry casting website, My Entertainment World, Venom will enter production in the fall of 2017, about 1 year before it's released. It's been listed as a action-horror-sci-fi film.
A horror movie.
Mm-hmm.
Dash comedy-love story.
Filled with horrors.
So yeah, we'll see how that movie comes out.
Take my money.
Sad news in the gaming world. GameStop closing stores after a surprisingly slow holiday season.
All of them?
A lot of them.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I'm kind of surprised.
I know.
I think that would be like an ongoing thing because like games are like more popular than ever now.
My old Zumba instructor, Lorenzo, he works at the GameStop in North Haven. They're closing down his store.
Maybe it's because things are leaning more toward downloadable stuff.
I'm assuming. And
yeah.
a lot of people rip games. So.
With things like Steam, which is like a, you know,
Steam
you can download
is popular.
Games.
Yeah.
More and more companies are leaning toward that.
Well, this is what happened. It says, according to the video game retailer's fourth quarter financial report, hardware sales dropped 29.1% and new software sales declined 19.3% compared to 2015. Overall, total sales dropped 13.6% during this quarter. Mm. Unsurprisingly, the news caused GameStop's stock to plunge 13% on Friday. So they're talking about closing down a few of their stores, a couple hundred from what I'm reading. Expects to shutter up 3% of its 7,500 locations, which works out to be 225 stores.
Oh, so that's pretty significant.
That sucks. Yeah. Not good news for GameStop.
Do you think it's because people are leaning more towards PC gaming instead of console?
I don't know. I know Xbox isn't doing that good right now.
Yeah.
I know they just released Mass Effect Andromeda, and there's been a lot of bad reviews about that game. Mainly just the beginning, not like towards the end from what I'm hearing, but apparently like they really rushed it with the animation and stuff. Like, the animation is really shitty on the faces and stuff. And like, I've seen it and I'm like, yeah, it's not that good.
Yeah.
But I hear the story is really good, you know, but other than that, Xbox's sales are down and PS4 is up.
We're like at the dawn of the whole VR movement.
That might be
a significant thing too.
Yeah, it's so expensive though.
It's expensive now, but all technology is expensive.
Two or three years from now.
Yeah.
It'll be accessible to
I know if you get the PlayStation VR, like the setup, it's at least $500 up front. Like, and the Batman one that came out, it's good, but it's only an hour long.
Yeah.
Like, you could play through the entire game in 1 hour. Like,
right. Because it takes a lot more time to create those games. You're creating a whole world, I would assume.
Well, I mean, it's not really all that different than what they're doing now.
That's true. But I mean, I would think that the technology that has to go into it is a lot more difficult.
I think if anything, I mean, it just takes like, probably like a bigger processor and all that, keep it running.
Well, speaking of Batman, the new Justice League trailer dropped on Saturday, and we all just saw it.
Right on my foot.
I think it looks better than Batman v Superman, but time will tell.
It looks fucking great. We've been fooled before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have we?
Well.
I mean, did you honestly think that Batman v Superman was going to be good based on
the trailer? I remember all of you sitting there creaming your little shorts over it.
When it first came out, the first trailer came out, it looked great.
When I saw Jesse Eisenberg on screen, I was like,
no. I don't know. I mean, my question is, who are they fighting? I mean,
they're fighting.
Good question.
No, I know. They're fighting. Eventually, they're going to be fighting Darkseid because those are all his minions from Apocalypse that are coming.
Yeah,
they didn't make it very clear.
We saw a hint of that. Well, Batman vs Superman.
He did in the whole nightmare scene when Batman was wearing that trench coat and stuff, and like trying to find the kryptonite to take out Superman. Like those things flying in the background, those are all Darkseid's minions.
Okay. Well, yeah, so,
and then you saw the emblem too in the field.
I'm assuming that Steppenwolf is probably the main villain. Because
for this movie, yeah.
The whole band? I was just about to say. They have hinted at that.
They're
making a comeback.
Born to be wild.
Well, that's what the soundtrack is.
Well, because in the ultimate cut of Batman vs. V Superman.
He was in there.
Yeah, he was in it at the end.
Yeah.
It didn't look anything like Steppenwolf from like the comics or the cartoons.
No,
but
they're like, it's Steppenwolf. And I'm like, who? Like,
I remember I had the Steppenwolf Superpowers action figure. I love that thing. It's an awesome axe.
Nice.
Do it have like a spring arm?
Yeah, of course. That's he squeezes his legs and he does this.
I do the same.
Makes a jam version of his arm.
Squeeze my legs
and go to town.
I'm just waiting to see. I'm just waiting to see when the second trailer is going to drop because the movie doesn't come out until this November. I'm waiting to see what they're going to do with Superman because he's still technically dead right now.
Yeah.
But he's going to be revived.
Yeah.
And there's no sign of him in this trailer at all.
Even the
hero shot has the
you
four
see
of
Lois,
them.
But
they'll bring him back at the very end of the movie.
That's what I'm thinking.
Like,
but they're probably going to make him evil at first.
That would be amazing.
Yeah,
that'd be kind of cool. I'd like to see an evil Superman.
Because they've been hinting at that black Superman suit.
I always root for the bad guy.
Hey, just because he's black doesn't make him evil. We at the League of Extraordinary Frontmen
fully support
the black
African American community.
The black costume
and all
community.
All of the African-American superheroes throughout history.
Why did we make me sound racist?
Yeah, jeez. You're processed.
That's why we're here.
Not talking about black people.
Well, hello there.
Is that it for news?
Hi, Josh.
He knows what's up.
If he was here right now, he'd be like, nope. Nope. We gotta get him back on the show.
Yeah. That's it for news?
Yeah, that's it for news. Oh, yeah. No, top 10 comics.
Except for it's not.
Top 10 comics with AJ.
Coming at ya!
Top 10!
Please record that.
That would be awesome.
I hope you're recording it.
Make a jingle. I need a transition for that.
Top 10 comics for March 22nd. Action Comics, number 976. Captain America, Steve Rogers, number 14. Detective Ooh. Comics, number 952. Extraordinary X-Men, number 20. Flash, number 19. Hal Jordan and the Green Lanterns Corps, number 17. Invincible Iron Man, number 5. Iron Fist, number 1. Why? Because of that terrible Netflix series.
Mm. Kevin just
it was okay. Anyway.
Yeah.
Star Wars, Darth Maul, number 2. And Unworthy Thor, number 5. You can find all these comics at Legends of Superheroes, located at 1655 Straits Turnpike Suite, number 4 in Middlebury, Connecticut. Open 6 days a week. Closed on Tuesdays. And just like your local music scene, what?
You should tell Bob that we sent you.
No. Support your local businesses. So go buy some comic books today and tell
like
Bob.
Never listen.
Tell Bob the League of Extraordinary.
You just wait for your turn to talk.
And I am done.
That was on purpose. All right, just Scott. Like your local music scene, tell Bob.
I want to rock and roll all night.
And have a wonderful time.
Bob's at a store. I was like, why the fuck is everybody telling me about the music scene? I don't care. This is like the 10th person that came in.
Yeah, he's like, I don't even like music.
All right, Scotty's not here this week, so I am in charge of toys, and he will regret that.
Toys, wonderful toys.
All right, new in toys this week.
I haven't been in a band in 6 months.
And you're hearing voices.
And it's starting to show.
All right. First on the new toy list, we have the Lilo Aura 2, the world's most intelligent oral sex simulator. Don't like the black? We have
what
other colors,
the fuck?
Too. There is a blue version, a mauve version. What color do you think that is?
Puce.
Wait.
Is this really it?
Well, these are toys.
The most intelligent oral sex simulator. Oh
so
my god.
So it does come in different colors.
This is real.
It looks like it's,
it looks like it would be cold.
A stainless steel or maybe some kind of plastic.
Maybe.
Did anyone see that video of that woman teaching everybody how to deep throat with a fucking cucumber?
No.
My coworker's ML job showed me that. I got so grossed out.
I don't know all the details about this, but it is available on myfirstblush.com.
Oh my god.
And if you want it, it's yours for $189.
Well, that's a fair price.
It is.
Dude, you're awesome.
Next up on the toy list.
Oh, this just stepped up to toy news by a long shot. Scott, you gotta step
next
it
up,
bro.
Next up on new toys is iRide Sit-On G-Spot Dual Motor Vibrator. This one comes in a nice vibrant pink.
Oh, you gonna send me the pictures of those? Right?
Oh my god!
That looks like a fun time.
Yeah. It's basically like a seat.
It looks like a seesaw.
Kind of like a seesaw. Like
a little sit and spin.
A little seesaw that
it's
you sit right on the center.
It's a seesaw.
Ooh, remember yeah. Sit and spin?
And it has a phallic shape rubber thing sticking straight up, so you sit on it for your comfort.
Oh my god.
iRide goes for $126. Again, you can find this on myfirstblush.com. They're not a sponsor.
South Park episode about that?
What's
Mr. Garrison, he made some like brand new car, but it like involved like jerking motions and getting fucked in the ass by something.
Oh no!
That's the reason why I don't watch that show.
That one.
My first blush. I mean, hashtag not spawn, but maybe.
Here's another one. It's called Sex in the City Rabbit Habit Vibrator. The Rolls Royce of vibrators.
Oh my god.
This one comes in a nice shade of transparent purple.
Translucent.
It's a fair price of $80. If you look at the picture, it looks like you can get multiple different pleasure points.
Like, suppose.
It's fun and budget friendly.
Yeah. I believe it spins. rotates.
With that hook thing on it, though.
And, yeah. It looks like it's there to tickle the clit.
I'm new from Bandai.
Let me read the description.
I'm waiting to see the DC line of those. You know, you get the Batman one, you get the Superman one.
Yeah, they really should branch out.
Red Hood.
So this Kryptonite. One is a Rolls Royce of vibrators, as said by Oprah Winfrey.
Oh my God.
Become addicted and experience the new Sex in the City rabbit habit vibrator just like Charlotte. So this is from, as featured on Sex in the City.
I hate to admit that.
As seen on Sex in the City and Oprah.
Who the fuck
the most popular
Sex
rabbit vibrator
City?
Ever. Multiple vibration speeds for lip-biting orgasmic pleasure. The head rotates and stimulates your deepest erogenous zones. Five modes for pulsating, escalation, and vibration.
Ew.
Soft rabbit ears tickle and tease.
Ew.
Completely free of phthalates, latex, and other toxins.
Well, at least it won't
so
get
that's
cancer.
Good.
For all you lonely nerds out there are listening, this is for you.
It's also compatible with most water-based lubricants, if you're concerned. Easy clean and maintenance with any toy cleaner. See what else
this
we have
so
on here.
So perfect for the title of the episode.
It's true.
The number of the episode.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, I mean, Scott and Jeannie are usually the ones that do the toy reviews. They're currently reviewing all of these, and then they'll come
they
back
are.
With these.
I wonder if they have any of these.
This is a good one. This one also by Lilo. It's called the Ina 2 Luxury Rechargeable Rabbit Vibrator. We're sticking with a rabbit theme. This one is actually really cool looking.
Oh my god, it looks like a cactus. Or an onion.
If you're not happy with the green color, it also comes in orange and purple.
That's actually funny because, like, the old internet show that I used to be a part of, we had a segment called Go Fuck Yourself with a Cactus. Somebody that week that would piss us off or something like
just
that.
For,
so
for size reference?
Yeah. Oh, my
tell.
God, yeah.
Ew!
it's a good size. It looks like there are it kind of branches off, forks off. The larger size looks for vaginal penetration, and the smaller size you stick in your ass. This one goes for $189, which I think is a fair price for this. Let's watch the video.
No, really? There's a fucking video.
Oh god.
Features. Yeah, if you can read it, please.
Features are, oh god. Dual pleasure points and flexible stimulator for immersed satisfaction. FDA approved silicone safe for smooth sensation.
FDA approved.
Easy to use controls. Oh no. Oh, it's very purple.
That's a nice profile.
It looks like like your iPod. Increase vibration strength and cycle through different vibrations for your pleasure. Oh, you can turn it off on the handle and hold for 5 seconds and the light will turn off. Why would you want it lighted?
Why wouldn't you want it lighted? That's the question.
Unlock by pressing 5 more seconds and the light will turn on when the device is active. Why would you light that area up? Why would you, there's no, always charge them before your first use, otherwise they're not going to work.
Yeah.
Insert the charger in the socket. The light will pulsate. Okay, this is just like, charge your dildo. Yeah. It will emit a steady glow. It will last for approximately 2 hours. Why are you using it for 2 hours?
Why wouldn't you use it for 2 hours?
Why not 8?
Hygiene and care. The antibacterial cleaning spray to use before after each use gives you total peace of mind. When cleaning with water, always use premium antibacterial solution because your hole is dirty. Waterproof for easy cleaning.
Ooh, it comes in a nice bag.
And it comes in a lovely bag for your discretion. Do not boil or use a metal scour. So, like, maybe clean it before it gets all crusty, bitches.
You can have fun on the go.
Oh, it's protected by a warranty. So don't take, or don't forget to take advantage of the full warranty coverage.
For $190, it better be warranty.
You can just register, log in, follow the directions, and you can register your product.
Yeah.
So they know that you have it.
Does it have an app?
Oh.
Please, I wish it did.
I'm screaming, I'm sorry. Okay. Your ears are now exploding.
This is going in the...
the show notes?
Shopping cart.
Rachel, you're in for a surprise, dear.
2 hours. It only lasts 2 hours, unfortunately.
Lasts longer than flowers.
True. and one more.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
This is the last item on the toy list.
Don't make me do it again.
It's a Batman vibrator.
This is the Fetish Fantasy Bondage Swing. It looks like it can be attached to your ceiling, and it has multiple straps you can use. Let me show you an example.
Ah!
Oh, my God.
Ah! Oh!
I don't have one of these in this color.
Well, are they actually posing, or are they actually...
It's like when you're riding a motorcycle.
Oh, my God, why? Bars. That looks... No.
Let me give you a different angle.
Oh, don't be such a prude.
Oh, no.
Oh, he's, yeah.
No.
She's wearing underwear. It's
why
okay.
Why would you have to swing for that? Just use a bed like boring people.
Again, why wouldn't you want this?
You could use it in combination with that cactus fucker.
And finally, if you want a rear entry position.
Okay. I mean, there's
the
that.
The only problem with this is trying to explain or trying to come up with an excuse why you have a... latch
swing.
Some sort of thing hanging from your ceiling.
It's exercise equipment.
I mean, we do have a hook, but over I mean,
Michael Keaton, Batman.
Yeah.
I got a bad back.
Yeah.
Surprisingly enough, it looks like a lot of the lifts that we use
I'm
at
training
school
to, be Batman.
To put the old people in baths.
Yeah, kind of looks like that.
Kind of looks like that.
This goes for a low price of $150. Add to cart.
Oh.
Let's see. Have you ever had sex on a spaceship? This is part of the description.
I can't say that I have.
Indulge your deepest sexual fantasies with Fetish Fantasy's amazingly easy-to-use bondage swing.
AJ, we are not getting that.
Keep talking.
With straightforward and super simple setup, the swing is the perfect beginner toy.
A beginner this toy?
Yes.
It's, I can't figure out how to use it.
It's made for you, not for gymnasts. Want to know the best part? Its patented harness and strap system, this is patented by the way.
Oh, okay.
Is like floating in a spaceship. Haven't you always wanted to have sex in space?
What is the weight limit on this thing?
I think we might find out. let's see.
If it's north of 500
pounds, that's how simple
pounds,
it is. You can now try all sex positions you've ever dreamed of with no need for stretching or contorting yourself. That's part of the fun, though.
No more worrying about if I can make those poses, dear.
Super easy assembly, made for normal couples, not gymnasts. Try all positions in zero gravity sex. Simply adjust to all shapes and sizes. Okay.
Is gravity that much of an issue?
Wrist and ankle cuff rings for the full bondage experience.
Anal cuff rings?
No,
ankle. I thought you said anal.
Did you want me to look up anal cuffs?
No.
I'm sure they exist somewhere.
And his wrist and ankle restraints are extremely strong and perfect for a complete bondage lover's playtime. Best of all, though, is that it fits all shapes and sizes. Don't worry about this heavy-duty swing breaking anytime soon. It's built to last. So buy one right now and blast your sex life to the moon.
Blast!
Product specifications. Now listen up because this may be important to you.
Oh, okay.
Material is comprised of nylon and metal. Weight of the product is 9.75 pounds.
How can it hold 750 pounds?
It's magic. Includes two large and two small padded supports, two connector hooks, two wrists and two ankle restraints, steel eyelet bolts and link chain, torso spring, and metal support bar, eye mask, and setup instructions. Do they install these? Let's see if there's a question and answer section.
Will they come to my home? Does it work on... Oh, God, what was the... Does it work for bats?
unfortunately, there are no reviews done for this, and I don't see a Q&A section, so I can't inquire if they install.
Can you come to my sex dungeon and install this for me?
I think that's going to be it for toys this week. Let me just see if there's anything
else. Thank God.
Let me just see if there's anything else that sticks out.
I see what you did there. Yeah.
He-Man replica Thunder Dildo. For those who think they have the power.
And a blow up battle cat.
A blow up battle cat.
Oh, here's one.
Oh, God.
This would be the last item on the toy list. Here it is. My first silicone surge 10 functional vibrating beginner butt plug.
What the fuck?
This one received 4 stars, so this has to be a pretty good product. This one does come in a sleek black.
Ew, look how big it is.
Looks like it's easy to clean. Looks like it's easy to clean. I don't see any scale for comparison. Oh, there is a video.
It's got Scott right next to it.
The video.
Not again. This is all you, AJ.
Oh, I'm good.
Imagine this music while you have this thing in your ass.
Oh, God.
Exclusively by NAS Toys. Takes anal by play NAS to the next
toys.
Level.
NASA Toys?
With a remote control and 10 Shooting different functions, face. Boundless pleasure and play awaits you and your partner. At 5 inches in length, 4.5 inches in diameter,
ew!
This product is the ultimate in anal satisfaction. Constructed on a soft velvet feel and an intense vibrating tip, it will bring you back for more and more.
No.
But wait, don't leave this item in the bedroom.
As a remote
the
control.
Waterproof feature allows the pleasure to continue in the bathtub, shower, or pool.
Ew, pool!
It comes in your choice of blue or black.
Blue or black.
The power butt plug comes ready with 3 G13 batteries.
Color matters.
These things, it mystifies me.
Why butt plugs? Like, why are they obsessed about butt plugs?
Why would you care about the color when it always comes out brown?
Have you ever tried a vibrating plug? Enjoy luscious anal pleasure with a new My First Silicone Surge 10-function vibrator beginner butt plug. With 10 different functions of vibration and pulsation, you'll be able to find the setting that suits you best. The sleek, tapered form allows for easy and pain-free insertion. Apply lashings of lube to get the full anal experience. 10 stunning functions and vibrating for amazing anal pleasure. Made with surgical-grade silicone. Oh, okay. Easy to use remote control for hands-free enjoyment. suction cup base for attachment to any flat surface. Yeah. That's important.
Oh, so you can like put it on a window?
Yeah.
Shower wall?
Absolutely.
Window? Yeah.
What, you don't?
I just figured that out.
And if you are a mirror, see how you're doing?
Yeah, if you're narcissistic, you can actually stick it to a mirror.
Ew.
Pretend you're fucking yourself.
Ew.
Attach your surge to any flat surface for hands-free riding. Control it with its remote control to easily give yourself pleasure you've always wanted. Made with hospital-grade silicone, your surge is purely body-safe and easy to clean and maintain. Order your My First Silicone Surge 10-function vibrator beginner butt plug right now and get... Oh, listen to this. This is a deal. Order it right now and get the filled-up, amazingly erotic anal experience you've always wanted. Here are the specifications. The length is 5 inches. Again, this is a beginner one, so it is only 5 inches. Insertable length is 4 inches. So you will get 4 inches of this in your ass.
Ew.
Girth is 4 inches at its largest point.
That's so...
That's 4 inches in circumference.
That's
not
bigger.
Not 4 inches wide.
Oh. So 4 inches around. So it's at least like 2 inches around. That's bigger than any shit I've taken in my entire life.
Oh, you might have to double up.
width is 1.1 inches at the largest point.
Okay.
So... That's material silicone. It does take 2 AAA batteries, and they are not included. So make sure you stop at the drugstore and pick up batteries before this comes in. Or you can go onto Amazon and order this and batteries. So you can get them at the same time.
Commonly ordered together.
If you're worried about the weight, it is 5.76 ounces. So this one does not come with a carry case,
that's
unfortunately.
Unfortunate.
I would suggest getting the bright blue ones so you can do a thorough cleaning.
Yeah, you don't want to order a brown one. No. This thing's never getting clean.
If you're wondering if other people have ordered this and like the product, I'll give you at least one review.
Oh, good lord.
Bought this fun toy with my girlfriend. We've always been really into butt toys, but this one really takes the cake. Let that sit in. My girlfriend absolutely loves this toy, and we always use it when we're feeling like turning things up a notch. She thinks it's so hot when I'm the one controlling the remote.
Ew!
Awesome. So that's going to wrap up this week's toys. I hope you enjoyed it. And this is what happens when you leave toys in my hands.
I have to go take a shower now. I need some therapy. I feel used.
Is anybody in the mood for chocolate ice cream?
No.
Can we have one cup for that?
Yeah, let's get some soft serve.
Just do one cup.
One cup. Yeah.
No, all right, that's going to wrap up new toys. We're going to take a break and come back with live show and tell.
I'm going outside.
Show and tell time!
Yay!
Welcome to live show and tell. Hey, Facebook.
Hello.
Hello.
It's just the four of us today.
The Fantastic Four.
You want to see something gross? Yeah,
look up my nose.
I can see right up your nose.
All right, it's going to be a quick one, so who wants to go first?
I'll go first.
All right.
Mine's not really, to you guys it might matter, but... Oh. To you guys, it might matter. To me, it's okay. All right. So this one right here, I got for my birthday from the Lenningtons.
Ooh,
nice.
I've got some Pez dispensers of a stormtrooper, one of the elite soldiers of the Imperial Army. I've got Darth Vader, and I have the Death Star.
That's cool.
That's awesome.
Yeah. And a customized tin.
Nice.
That's really cool.
And no, I will not be giving this to anybody. So this is really cool. I like that. My cousin used to collect Pez dispensers. He had a ton of them in his room growing up. I don't know if he still has them, but I'm pretty sure he had some of these.
The candy is made in Red Orange, Connecticut.
Yeah.
If you drive by the factory, you can smell what flavor they're making.
Yeah. There is a museum, the Pez Museum.
Yeah, I want to go.
Red Orange. I've been there a couple times. Yeah. It's really fucking cool.
And it gives you all the info on the back of each character. So that's really cool, too.
Yeah, Pez dispensers are still, like, a really highly collectible thing.
Mm-hmm. I have to get in contact with my cousin. I want to know if he still has them, because that would be really cool.
Yeah, some of the older ones from, the 50s and 60s are worth a couple $100.
I know he's up in Iowa, but
millions.
If he still has them, I want to see if he could try to, like, take some pictures and send them to me. That would be really cool. So...
Neato.
If you have a chance, go to Orange, Connecticut. To the museum.
I'm trying to think of
really cool. They have like all the Pez dispensers.
It's off Boston Post Road. I'm trying to think of the exit number on 95. I can't remember though.
Yeah, I'll do that for you.
It's neat.
It is.
Neat.
And as soon as you walk in, there's a Pez motorcycle.
Cool.
It's pretty awesome. Cool.
A Pez motorcycle?
Pez motorcycle.
I'm trying to imagine what.
Dispenses giant Pez out of the tailpipe.
Like it's just made out of bricks?
Pez bricks?
It's
Pez bricks.
Does it flip up?
It's hard to describe.
Does it flip up?
And then no, it doesn't.
Pez come out.
So it's just a motorcycle.
And somebody spray painted Pez on it.
The really cool thing is they have Pez dispensaries where there's all different kinds of flavors.
Yeah.
And then you can get a bucket. And you can just fill a bucket.
Oh, that's awesome.
That's cool.
Full of Pez.
That's awesome.
Any kind
you
of
leave
flavor
there
you want.
Like this.
Wow. Yeah. Like an all you can eat buffet.
And it's hard to stop eating them.
That's so little.
Right, yeah. You just gobble them up.
It's
really
a whole new meaning of pill poppers. Anyway, continuing with the Star Wars theme, I've got my Star Wars collection on Blu-ray.
Yay!
Is that all of them?
Yeah, all of them minus The Force Awakens and Rogue One.
Wow.
Yeah, the original.
The original and the prequels.
Yeah, and the prequels.
That's awesome.
I got this at Walmart for $35. And why? Because it was in the wrong section.
Ah.
It was supposed to be for way more.
I'm sure.
And I was like, no, I saw this in the $34 section.
Yeah, they're good about that.
They are.
Yeah, so, you know.
Well, as huge of a corporation as they are.
Yeah, they can.
It's law in Connecticut. Yeah. If it's where it's not supposed to be, and I say, hey, that's what it said, I get that price. Yeah. So. Yeah, that's got six movies for $34. $35. Awesome.
How much is it regular?
That is a score.
It's got to be 60-some-odd dollars.
No, it was originally going for like 90.
Was it?
That's yeah. So, and it
has. Oh, because it's Blu-ray. Yeah,
and,
okay.
And it's Blu-ray, yeah.
Yeah, so.
So come
we'll,
on!
We'll be going to local Walmarts and misplacing that
yes.
for all of you.
Or what we can do is like go in teams.
There you go.
Ooh. Like I can go in and place it in the bin, and then you guys pick it up in the bin. That
yeah.
way,
yeah, put it in the $5 bin.
Yeah.
Yeah. This one was $5.
If they review the cameras, you know, it wasn't you that
was it.
Yeah.
Wow.
See, I'm thinking.
And then you go to another Walmart and you do the same thing for him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well,
they'll never know.
Maybe.
Good thing Walmart doesn't watch our podcast.
Yeah, right? Who the fuck are we, right?
So there's your Blu-ray scam right there.
I'm going to heat up some water for my show and tell.
Nice.
Ooh.
So I could show you all.
Heated water activated?
It's heat water activated.
There you go.
I'll go next just to carry on the Star Wars theme.
What?
What? I picked this one up the other day. This is the Empire Strikes Back notebook.
Nice.
It's got the full screenplay and an assortment of storyboards.
Very cool.
From the movie.
Wow.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's very awesome.
I like looking at storyboards. Where'd you pick this up at?
I picked it up on Amazon, actually.
Nice.
It was only like a few bucks. This is from like 1980-something. So it's kind of like a vintagey thing, but it's interesting because like Yoda in there looks like kind of reminds me of how he looked in the Empire Strikes Back adaptation from Marvel.
Oh where, yeah,
you remember like how he had like long legs and stuff?
Yeah, it's a little weird looking.
Yeah, you know, and it's based on you know the concept sketches of Yoda because they hadn't finished the movie yet, and so you know. Because that was done, you know, as like a pre-production thing. Like, you know, I guess they hadn't finalized the design, so.
Huh. I guess it's easier to control a puppet when it's like shorter, too. So, I'm guessing.
Yeah, exactly. The days before CGI.
I still can't get over that bad lip reading of Seagulls stopping
out. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Fucking Luke. I have jump.
I could be a backpack while you
I have to admit, I actually downloaded that on iTunes, and every time I'm having a bad day, like, I'll just play it in my car, and I just laugh hysterically.
We had a run where, you know, for about, like, a couple of weeks where Luke wanted to hear that every day.
rocking and rolling.
He still loves that part where he goes like, it's so funny.
What's the Obi-Wan one that they did?
Oh, God.
That was fantastic. Yeah. That was brilliant.
Oh, the Bushes of Love.
Yeah. They were waiting in the bushes for us. They were waiting for the Bushes of Love.
But, one thing I thought was kind of cool is the picture of the Emperor.
Oh, wow.
Kind of reminds me of Supreme Leader Snoke
a little bit. Yeah.
Except it's not.
Hmm.
Because Snoke is Snoke, right? Because
Snoke is Snoke. Yeah, Snoke is the Emperor! But yeah, I like the drawing style and the storyboards.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's kind of cool to like, see some of the differences, like how Yoda looks in comparison to how he looks in the final.
Holy shit, yeah.
Yeah, it's very different.
Yeah. Just a little bit. I mean, the ears are there, but...
Yeah.
Oh. Noich.
Yeah. So, yeah, I thought it was kind of cool.
Very cool. Alright, who's next?
I got hot water.
You got hot water? You want to do yours?
So, I got this for a birthday present.
Oh.
And I've been waiting for it for a long time.
Where'd you get it from?
From the Jays. And I love it, and I use it every fucking day. Well, this is my studying mug. It helps me think. And on one side, it's got the TARDIS, and on the other side, it's a mystery. Oh. What could possibly go there? It's almost like it was meant for the TARDIS. I'm going to try and do this without burning your table.
What's your book?
Oh, shit. Can I have that napkin?
Yeah.
So, as you can see...
Is it transforming? I can't tell.
It will, in just a moment. It should.
Oh, I see something.
Yeah, the TARDIS on this side is starting to go away and transferring onto this side.
Oh, shit. Fucking witchcraft.
Yes.
You're a witch. You're a witch.
Very cool.
Yeah, it's my super study mug. Helps me think, get A's on all my tests. You can take a picture of the other side, too, there. It's disappearing.
It's gone. How about a magic trick?
Yeah.
I'm gonna make this TARDIS disappear.
So, yeah. I've been wanting
it's
one
gone.
Of these.
It's a little less violent.
Yeah. I've been wanting one of these for a long time. We can pass it around if you want. You just gotta be careful.
That's okay. I don't want
to. I don't want to burn myself.
But,
that's
it's pretty
awesome,
neat.
Yeah.
I love it.
I've seen, like, heat-activated cups before, like
mm-hmm.
the lightsaber ones.
Yep.
But this is the first time I've ever seen something that, you know, disappears on one side and appears on the
yeah,
other side.
Yeah, it's really cool. It's like it's going away from the street and ending up in space.
Yeah, they've been very popular. Mm-hmm. I've seen like, Dragon Ball Z ones where, like, Goku, like, turns Super Saiyan mm-hmm. as soon as you pour coffee in there or something like that. Like, his hair just turns bleach
blonde. Yeah, one of my friends got one of those.
That's cool. Yeah, there's one that I saw that I really want to get. It's the cockpit of the Millennium Falcon. When you pour the water in, it goes into hyper.
Oh, nice. Yeah. That would be cool.
Really cool.
So, very cool.
For
yeah.
all my studying needs.
Oh, yeah, it's gone.
All right.
Wow.
All right. I think it was last week, maybe, that I showed you a quick picture of an example from me painting something, some kind of toy. Pull the picture up first. Should have had this prepared. Hold on.
Oh my god.
Okay, here it is. This is what the original looks like.
You need a guillotine?
This is something I picked up at Savers in one of those little baggies that hang on the walls.
Oh, I see.
Okay, it's you see, it's like monotone plastics and stuff like
that.
Yeah,
shitty.
A couple of paints here, applications here and there, but it's mostly just like whatever color plastic it was.
Shitty.
The cool thing about these things, though, is like there's so much detail in them, and like the toy companies don't take advantage of it.
Like within the mold?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's like these guys, they sculpt these things, even with figures and stuff like that, but like when it comes to painting them, they don't highlight those details. It's like so much is lost. So... what I did.
Oh, look at that.
Shit.
What I did a complete repaint of it.
Wow.
And brought out all the details.
It looks like real metal.
You can see, yeah. You can see like the bullet holes in there now. Like I didn't do anything but paint this.
The barbed wire on the outside, that was all you or was that there?
The barbed wire was there, but it was just like one tone color.
Looks so cool.
So there's a few different paint applications on that to make it look rusty, a little bit rusty.
How long did it take to do the paint?
This took me an afternoon.
Yeah.
A few hours.
Days.
Slaved.
No, this really wasn't a lot to it. A lot of just like dry brushing and adding like washes. Washes is like a watered down paint. Sits in the crevices to make it look like it's like shaded and stuff.
It
like
looks
that.
Really weathered. It's cool.
This is all simple dry brushing. And I threw a little guy in there. The top looks like wood now
mm-hmm.
instead of just like some generic plastic
yep.
thing.
Yeah.
And the gun actually looks like a gun.
That's
yeah,
so cool.
Yeah, because it's the thing. Like they took the time to sculpt.
Yeah,
sculpt out like the wood
sculpting.
Grain and everything. Yeah.
But they didn't paint it.
Yeah.
Now who made that piece originally?
This is by a company named Chet Mai. They make like military figures and stuff like that. The figures are absolute garbage,
mm-hmm.
but the playsets are fantastic. Like this is a perfect example of it. I mean, all the details they put into it. They even put like the gun belt in there. course, that was painted.
That's so
I painted that using metallic Sharpies.
Nice.
Really?
Yeah. So, and then I put these sandbags on there, too. Also from Chap May, from a different kit. So I find these every once in a while. Sometimes I see them in the store for, like, really cheap, and I pick them up.
And the playsets aren't meant to be, like, you know, you bring them home and paint them. They're meant to be just played with.
Lucille says, what figure do you have inside right
That's
now?
So That's cool. a G.I. Joe Steel Brigade, 25th anniversary.
Custom painted?
Custom, yeah, he's customized, too.
Gripworks.
They come with
Gripworks. There you go.
that figure kind of comes with a goofy helmet that I can't stand, so I replace the helmet with something else. And
you should seriously do this shit for a living, like just like paint figures for people.
That's
and just,
so neat.
You should put them online, like you know, restore G.I. Joe figures.
You can check out my Instagram page.
Yeah,
Agrippa93.
There you go.
And I post all my work on there.
There you go. It's not just band stuff.
You can see the how-to on Agrippa's lab on our
YouTube
there's
a trick
page.
To it. Like, I'll throw up a bunch of my painted stuff.
Yep.
Get a whole bunch of followers. I'm like up to...
And then just throw in some band stuff.
Yeah, every once in a while, band stuff.
So. Baiting them. Yeah, I see.
yeah, the
strategy.
Who would have thought that toys would be clickbait?
exactly what it is.
Seal says, I follow it!
Hey!
I like that it smells like paint.
Yeah.
I don't see that. Let's get you under the light.
So, yeah, I just glued those sandbags on there.
Sandbagging
them up.
Very cool. Deadpool approves.
it's all in scale for 1/18 scale figures, so it's perfect.
These finds are incredible.
I go to Savers all the time and look for stuff like
it's
this.
It's almost flea market season, too.
Yeah. Flea market opens April 2nd.
Mm.
I just found a flea market in Plainville today with Lady J.
Really?
It's over by Red Zone, like right down the road there somewhere.
What's that?
It's a bar.
Okay.
It used to be the firehouse.
Okay.
It's right down the road there. I forgot the name of it, but it's a flea market that's open Saturdays and Sundays. I believe it's on the second floor of this building, but they're open from like 9 to 4. We almost stopped by today, but...
I'm going to have to visit.
Yeah. Well... Maybe we could do it together.
Yeah, absolutely.
That'd be cool.
Nice.
We love flea markets.
Check out your local Savers.
Yes.
It's like 5 of them in Connecticut.
There's always a treasure trove.
Yeah. Well, that's it.
That's it for show and tell.
Have a lovely evening.
Bye.
Avida zen.
Do something we haven't done for quite some time. It's game time.
Woo!
Star Wars Mad Libs.
Excitement.
Let's do this shit.
All right, we'll start going around. AJ, adjective.
It's descriptive, right?
Mm-hmm.
Moist.
Do you know how many times I've had to say the word moist?
It's a default word. You might as well just put it in every one.
You show a weakness, and they just pounce.
Just when you go through that book, just like wherever it says adjective, just like fill out
moist.
It's got to be somewhere.
Person in the room.
Person in the room. Michelle.
Uh-huh. Here we go. This is what I get for suggesting we do a game. Kevin, a noun.
Clitoris.
God. I can't spell clitoris.
It's
a little known fact.
What is wrong with you? You're
one. I am the click commander.
Adjective. Gooey.
Ooh. It's getting sexy now.
Adjective. If you say moist again, I'm going to tell you.
Wet.
Come on, you knew that was coming.
Yes.
Martin ends up with same person in the room, so that's kind of a gimme. I'll give you another one.
All right.
Noun.
Butt plug to go with our toy theme.
Kevin, a noun.
Prostate.
Yeah.
Hopefully this works out.
Oh boy.
I think we're onto something, my
yes.
friend.
Noun. Rabbit.
Nice. All right.
Random.
No judgment.
Well, all of the dildos were some form of a rabbit.
True. Yeah, that was
She's a furries.
Well done. Well
a
done.
Verb.
Verb. Fucking.
I'm going to say fuck just because I know that's going to work better right. in this instance. Type of liquid.
Type of lube. Come on, that was so easy.
I was thinking jizz. I could have not jizz. Said that.
Jizz, that's so pedestrian.
Kevin, noun. Jizz.
Sloth.
Poor sloths. Okay, and last name. I'm going to say Frear.
Damn.
Ties it all together.
Okay, ready?
Let's hear it.
I don't know.
It's Jedi Training Diary by
yes.
Yoda.
Yes.
Mm. Actually, maybe Kevin can read it because he does a much better Yoda voice than I do.
Dear Diary.
Dear Playboy.
Learning I am. If this new Padawan is ready to be a moist Jedi. Michelle has shown talent with the Force. But Clitoris, he seems to be lacking. A Jedi warrior should not forget that they leave their gooey lightsaber, no matter how wet they were training the night before. Michelle was not able to use the butt plug to lift an X-wing prostate out of the rabbit yesterday.
Oh, nice.
Even when I said to fuck harder, and being dropped into the swampy lube I do not like. When a Padawan forgets to fasten the buckles on his sloth before backflips, the Force tells me there is another Frear. But take my chances with that one. I think I will.
That worked out pretty well.
That's fantastic. It's nice when they work out.
We're going to have to do a scroll on this one.
Yeah.
I'm going to get a picture of that. Okay, shameless butt plugs. Who's got what going on? When? And where?
There's definitely a theme tonight.
Shameless butt plugs.
Shameful.
The Agrippa 93 bash is now.
That's good. It works.
Well, I am wrapping up some video work for Vision Within that I shot at Cherry Street the other week. Just getting together some last-minute stuff for them. I still got a lot of other stuff to go through, but they only picked five, so I'm finishing up the five that they want. And I'm going to send it out to them, so hopefully you see it soon. They seem happy about it so far. So,
this was like one of your first major projects.
Yes.
What have you learned from it?
I need to get more lighting at Cherry Street.
Okay.
Plain and simple, especially for the drummer. But other than that, I think I need a stable cameraman up front. Mm-hmm. Sorry, Rob.
It's a learning process.
Yeah. I mean, like, you know...
You're still kind of new at this.
Yeah, I'm still kind of new. I'm running, like, six different cameras, you know what I mean, and an audio recorder at the same time, so I got to make sure those levels are okay, and you never know who's running sound that night, if they're going to spike or not, you know what I mean?
Right.
So, yeah. So,
you mean the sound's going to spike?
Yeah. Yes, the sound is going to spike.
Right.
But, no, Rob's good. I get what I can from his footage, so, you know, and he's really interested in doing this stuff, so he's
learning
a lot.
Process for
yeah,
him too.
Yeah, it is. So, he's a good kid. He's got a good head on his shoulders. He wants to be there and be a part of it. He loves it, so giving him a shot. So,
cool.
Just needs to learn a little bit, that's all. I do too, but it is what it is. But, yeah, look for Vision Within very soon.
Cool.
Frears?
I have some top secret projects going on.
Okay.
Right now.
That you can't tell anybody.
I can't tell anybody.
Oh.
No. I go to school.
No, I've, well, we've got, that, Crossing Rubicon lyric video.
Yes, we do.
I think they're going to be putting that out pretty soon.
I hope so, because it's been fucking weeks.
It's been that long.
It's been done.
It's been about a week.
Yeah.
Oh, it's been longer than that.
Oh, yeah, I guess a couple weeks.
Yeah.
But,
Scott didn't even know that it was done.
Oh.
And I had to point it out to him last week.
Are you serious?
I swear to God.
Oh, actually, you know, there was a funny story about it. because
this is great.
I sent it to him.
This is awesome.
And in the chorus, I put that the backing vocal is "Who are you?"
Yeah.
And he comes back and he's like, "Well, that's wrong. It's I am. It says I am."
Yeah.
And he talked to Brandy like a few days later. He's like, "Hey, what do you sing during that?" She's like, "Who are you?" He's like, "What?" She's like, we changed.
No shit.
She's like, "Yeah, we changed it in the studio."
That's what I always thought it was.
I thought it was too. When he told me that, I was like, "No, they're
really,
not."
Really? Because I thought I heard the opposite heard when I was line. Listening to the song. I'm so used to hearing like "I am," you know what I mean? So like when you said that, I was like, "No, I think that's wrong." That's funny. That is fucking funny.
It still makes sense. You know?
Oh yeah, but it's it changes the intent a little bit. Yeah. But,
look for "Who's Gonna Save You from Crossing Rubicon," the official lyric video made by yours truly and KJ Freer over here.
I don't know if he appreciates me telling that story, but
yeah, that's funny.
But he's not here to defend himself.
Episode 70, Kevin is a douche times 3.
Are we only at 3?
Yeah, I think it's
at least
times infinity.
But that should be making the rounds soon.
Well, their manager liked it. From what I heard,
yeah.
He really liked it a lot. So cool. And now he wants me to do more work for him, and I'm like, "Well, I'm already doing a documentary for you, and I'm kind of busy
yourself.
Right now."
Pace yourself.
Yeah, I've got another video I'm working on. That's gonna have like some animated stuff, and I'm working on an album cover for another band.
That's a new frontier for you, animation.
Well, it's not gonna be like total like animation, like frame by frame type mm-hmm. stuff. Kind of more like this one's more along the lines of like a motion comic.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
like
cool.
That,
oh,
like
that's pretty cool. Yeah,
that type of animation. So,
would you want to get into animation?
I wish I had the time.
Yeah.
You know, I've been kind of playing around with a little bit, doing like frame by frame stuff, but it's very time consuming.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think with all the software and technology we have, it would make it easier.
Yeah. For sure.
Here's a picture. Make what happens in between
that. You kind of go. You can do like a "How It Should Have Ended" kind of animation. You have like one still and
right.
then you just move them.
Right.
Yeah, I've wanted to get into trying like the flash animation.
Yeah.
One day when KJ Freer Designs really takes off.
What?
It seems to be taking off.
Well, when you can quit your day job.
Yeah.
True. Very true. Then you'd really be doing what you love doing.
Yeah.
That would be fantastic.
Yeah.
It's not out of the realm of possibility.
Did you do anything this weekend?
This weekend?
Yeah. It's coming up.
Yeah.
Weekend.
Do you know what's coming up?
Are
this
we doing
weekend?
Anything this
plans
weekend?
Plans coming up this weekend?
I think we're doing
Oh, fuck
some.
You both. This Saturday, Agrippa 93 at Cherry Street Station for Agrippa's annual bash. This is April 1st. Doors open at 7:30.
We're talking about it for 10 months.
Actually, going with the toy thing, I guess it would be the anal bash.
The anal bash. Agrippa's anal bash.
Change the name.
Kicking off,
not too late.
Kicking off the show is Jesse May playing some cello.
Cool.
We have
cello.
Black Market Uterus.
There's
playing.
Always room for cello.
We have Within the Abyss, Sever the Drama, who will be premiering their Horizon video
cool.
that night. That should be fantastic.
I was a young lad when that
yes.
video was recorded.
Long time ago. And of course, Agrippa 93 will be closing out the night. We'll have some guest stars on stage with us. Doors are $5, and if you wear your goggles, you get $2 off that.
Yes.
There will be cake.
Yes. That's what we were waiting for.
So come, there will be cake.
There will be 93 cakes.
You know, I have pastries at my shows, like, all the time, like, all the annual shows. I always notice, like, after I post, like, there will be cake.
You get a little bit,
the goings, like, you know, the number goes up a little bit more, so.
There will be 93% of a cake.
So that is this Saturday coming up, April 1st at Cherry Street Station. Lots of fun. Oh, and I've been reworking some videos, so if you've seen my show before, you've seen the videos.
Oh, they look fucking awesome. There will be changes. Awesome.
Thanks. You got to get a sneak peek of some of the new ones.
Oh, my God. I have so much to learn. I am such a young Padawan. You're my Jedi Master.
Oh, boy.
Speaking
of butt plugs.
Moist. Visit the Metal Syndicate website at metalsyndicate.ct.com for all their podcasts, including this one, which is Leaving the Store Frontmen.
Where am I?
Where am I? I'm surrounded by toys. Oh, yeah, the Frontman one.
I had to think. The Metal Syndicast, Thought Manicast, CT Metal Gear, the Paul Doll Podcast, Alternative Control Audio.
Yeah, don't bring your G.I. Joes to the Metal Syndicast.
Yeah, that'd be so embarrassing. You can check us out on OFNR every Friday at 7 p.m. You can also check us out on Facebook.com/The League of Extraordinary Frontmen. Also on Twitter, at OfficialLXF. And check out our YouTube page, too. Thanks for listening to The League of Extraordinary Frontmen. Please email all your questions, comments, arguments, corrections to LeagueofExtraordinaryFrontmen@gmail.com. And we'll read them right on the show. Going to wrap up episode 69.
Patreon.
Thank you. We have a Patreon on metalsyndicate-ct.com. You can go ahead and click on the Patreon button if you'd like to support all these great podcasts, all the services that we do for free to you at cost to us.
Because we don't rip off bands.
No.
We don't.
We are...
We don't fondle young children either.
Stop. You're cyberbullying.
I've had a couple beers, I'm sorry.
You're making true accusations. That's cyberbullying.
You can edit that out, right? Let's start again. The Patreon, yes.
So if you enjoy all these podcasts and you like hearing your band's name heard and advertised on our shows, help us out. We have a monthly setup, so if you want to contribute like $1 or $2 a month, that's going to go toward things like funding our website, helping us with the rent for the room that we record the Syndicast in, and if we get enough like per month, we'll start like making t-shirts and sending them out to Patreons. So that's our goal. Where was I? Oh, that's going to wrap up episode 69. Hope it's been a butt plug episode for you. and I hope that the Anarchies are still enjoying their 69 episode, that is. Thanks for listening.
They're probably enjoying it right now.